Now, a monocot root has the same sort of overall structure in that it has epidermal cells around the outside. It has an endodermis with a Casparian strip. It has a periderm, which is the first layer of the vascular cells from which lateral roots can emerge. But the orientation of the xylem in the vascular system, that's what's different and what gives away the monocot root compared to the dicot root. So in particular, the xylem, instead of being X-shaped in the middle, are bundles that are organized as a circle around that particular, around the inside of the vascular system. And then, whoops, the phloem wraps around the outside of the xylem. So instead of having an X with the xylem in the middle and phloem being in the lobes of the X, instead you have the xylem as discrete bundles in a circular arrangement around the inside of the stem, of the root, and then you have phloem around it. Now, sorry, I dropped my chalk, but this means that there are some cells in the interior and exterior here, and these cells in the vascular system are called pith. And you haven't seen that before. There's no pith in a dicot cell because the central part of the root is a solid mass of xylem. But in a monocot, the central part can be spongy parenchyma cells, and that's called pith.